Let's take a look at some of the highlights from our last episode of Windy City Poker Championship.
Raise. Sits down and just misses out on all the actions. Just gotta get going right out of the gate.
I gotta pretend I have aces right out
of the bat. I know, that's right.
There we go.
You've done this before, okay?
Yeah, we're going to the circle, right?
Exactly.
Now, just so you guys know, an extra bounty. If you knock out Dennis, we got a nice poker chip set as a prize from Poker Stars.
Nice.
You knock me out, you just get a t-shirt. So, you know, feel free to go after this guy.
What do I get if I knock you out? I already got a t-shirt.
Yeah, you got a t-shirt. I'll buy you a beer. Get you a Miller Lite.
I'll take it.
That's good at our table.
I like that.
Never a problem.
What are they now, 1 and 2?
1 and 2.
I'm gonna raise.
You can have it open.
What'd you have, ace four? Ace four?
No, queen deuce.
Oh, queen deuce? Oh, okay.
That he could be. That he could be.
Now that you've seen the highlights from our last episode, it's time to get back to the action from Chicago's only televised poker show, where 180 players are competing for their share of a $48,000 prize pool.
Welcome back to the season finale of the Windy City Poker Championship. I'm Scott Long.
And I'm Chris Cosenza from Annie Up Magazine. We're playing poker for local charities in the Chicagoland area. Let's see who's at the exclusive feature table.
Sitting down at our feature table in seat one is Richard Roper, a successful movie critic and columnist. Check out his movie reviews or read his blog at richardroper.com.
Next to Richard in position number two is Ruben Juarez. Ruben has run into some big hands so far in this tournament, and his chip stack has been steadily shrinking.
To Ruben's left in seat number three is professional poker player Bernard Lee.
To Bernard's left in position number four is Nico Paris. Nico considers himself a very calculated poker player. His hobbies include golfing and smelling great.
Next to Nico is Mike Lewis. Mike is from Tinley Park, Illinois. He is 38 years old and married. Mike has been playing poker for 4 years and happens to be sitting right next to his favorite player. What a treat!
To Mike's left is Dennis Phillips, a Team Poker Stars pro who made a deep run in the World Series main event in 2008 and followed it up with another deep run in 2009.
Sitting next to Dennis is Brian Amon. Brian is a young business owner and family man. His chip stack has gone up and down so far in this tournament.
And finally in position number eight is Paul Fisher. Paul and his brothers run a successful business selling garages. Paul once knocked Kirk out of a Windy City Poker Championship and for that received a wonderful t-shirt that said, "I knocked Kirk Fowler out of this tournament and all I got was this t-shirt."
Ace four at a re-raise.
I gotta get new LASIK. I can't say anything anymore.
I was wondering, was that an actual raise or were you colorblind?
100, 200 please.
No, he said raise.
Okay, blinds are 100, 200. Players started with 25,000 chips in this deep stack charity tournament. Last week, Richard Roper had control of the table at the end of the show, raising and taking it three times. Let's see if that continues today.
Action is here.
Nine deuce for Ruben. Bernard with a much better hand, ace 10.
Player raises.
Raises to six and a quarter. Bernard wasn't busy last show.
Six and a quarter to call.
Ace queen for Brian. This could be an interesting hand now, Chris.
Call.
He has position, but he is playing against a consummate pro.
Four and a quarter to you.
Richard, what are you doing?
He needs to fold.
425 more.
Four and a quarter.
Fold.
There you go.
Thanks. I like when movie critics listen to me.
Heads up action.
Okay, we're heads up. Brian has Bernard Lee dominated. Here's the flop. King of diamonds, seven of hearts, jack of diamonds.
Here.
Okay.
800 is the bet, sir.
$800 bet from Bernard.
Keeping control of the hand.
Ryan couldn't like that king any more than Bernard did, but Bernard has the advantage of acting first.
Just a call. Now they both missed this flop. They both have gut shots to a Broadway straight. A turn, four clubs. Bernard bets again.
14.
Raise.
Where else to raise?
4,000.
Wow, Brian 4, raises.
All day.
How much you have left?
I like what Brian's 15, doing here. He's 16, letting the dealer count on his chips for him so Bernard doesn't get any kind 17. Of reaction off of him. He knows he's a pro.
Player folds.
And Bernard lets it go. Nice play by Brian.
Nice hand. Nice bet.
That's how you take down a pro, Chris.
Well, I'm sure Brian is yucking it up with his friends at home, living in the moment.
I wonder how much one of these tables costs. What do you think?
Say again?
Wonder how much one of these camera tables costs. I'd love to have one of these in my poker club.
And that's kind of including the cameras behind us and all the labor.
Referring to the cameras. Well, the cameras that are down here, these guys, they don't know about the crotch cam? They haven't been told? Okay. All right. Sorry, I shouldn't have said anything.
The crotch cameras were not an option when Lucky Leahy's built this great table.
No, but they do make casino tables, TV tables, and, of course, home game tables. Bernard Lee limps with 6-5 of diamonds. Folds around to Brian, looks down at ace-jack.
Wonder what the market would be for a table with crotch cameras, Chris.
600.
600 is, he raises, makes it 400.
Probably huge in California.
Well, I know of one movie critic would like one.
Paul calls with suited 10-9.
Five more to you, sir.
Call.
Richard calls with a pair of deuces, hoping to flop a set.
Four more to you.
Ruben can't resist. He makes the call.
Bernard calls too. Five going to the flop.
Five to the flop.
Here's a flop. Nine of clubs, king of spades, four of clubs.
Begin here.
Paul out in front now with a pair of nines.
He also has advantage of position here.
I like the finger checks. It's on Paul. What's he going to do? Oh, he checks too. Here's the turn. Three of hearts.
Check.
Bernard now open-ended.
That sounds like it hurts.
You already have the garage world. Now you want the poker world? I mean, really.
12,000 is the bet.
Oh.
Oh, I'm sorry, my bad.
Dealer made a mistake there.
I apologize. 12.
Yes, it's 1,200.
What would I bet?
Holy cow. Woke him up.
Big difference between 1,200 and 12,000.
Floor.
Richard correctly gets out of the way.
Hey.
I just gave one. So does Ruben, but Bernard calls with his draw.
You got me believing it.
We will be heads up going to the river.
Jack of diamonds. Helps no one. Casual finger check.
Player checks.
I check.
Open up, Jack.
Paul says, you know what? I'm happy to take this down. Nine. Shows his nines.
Player shows
a wins
pair
a pot
nines.
Of 5,400.
Just a nine. It's good enough.
We'll be right back after this short commercial break.
Welcome back to Windy City Poker Championship, the only televised poker show from Chicago.
Let's take a look at the chip leaderboard for the featured table.
Line still 1 and 200.
Can we text other tables through this too?
Wouldn't that be great?
We need little miniature hockey sticks.
That'd be awesome.
Yeah.
Sure shot hockey. Yeah. You probably remember that.
There we might go. Be right. Absolutely.
Combination hockey poker.
Wait. You probably remember that. Is that a slam?
No, you and I are about the same age. I'm 71, so, you know.
Gives a whole new meaning to cross-checking.
Actually, I think I got a couple years on you, actually.
I doubt that. In fact, I'd take a prop bet on that.
Nico folds queen 10. Mike lets his queen 4 hit the muck.
Our hockey pro, Dennis. Suited ace.
Find the hockey pro in you.
500.
500.
All right. Player raise, got a raise here to 500 from our pro.
Brian has a bigger ace. Ace 10 makes the call.
Seems like Brian always wakes up with a bigger ace than the pros when they're in the pots together. Richard.
Richard accidentally calls.
I think he meant to throw his cards in there, not chips.
I put him on a 9-2. It's exactly what I put him on. And I didn't think I was going to fold. I mean, that's really what I did.
Pocket sixes for Bernard.
Right? So if he's not going to fold, then what am I going to make the bet?
No,
right?
I don't disagree with you.
What's the flop?
That first card's a good one for Bernard. Deuce, Trey, 6.
Action. You're in the button.
Set of 6s for Bernard.
Richard has an inside straight draw. Dennis paired his deuce.
Little something something for everyone.
13.
13. Player bets 1,300.
I like that bet. You know, he started with the aggression, and he continued with it, representing maybe a pair over the cards on the board. Richard contemplating his draw and pair.
Player calls.
Of course, Bernard is just licking his chops, loving all of these betting.
Call.
He just calls.
You've changed.
We can't be too scared of any card coming on the turn here.
Just give me a black.
So why not keep two customers in?
I'm sure he's hoping that Dennis has an overpair.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5.
No, one more black. One more black.
Sorry, brother.
No worries.
In the next production, Kirk will have to add a banker.
Here we do 200.
A reminder to the TV audience, let the dealer divide up your chips. Here's the turn. 10 of diamonds. That helps no one.
Player bets 28 is the bet.
28.
Bernard takes control of his hand from Dennis.
That's a nice size bet. He's just hoping that Dennis has a hand like Jack's.
Of course, we know it's going to be hard for Dennis to call, and he folds. To win a tournament, you've got to make some big calls at the right time. Richard has to figure out whether this is the right time.
And he makes the right decision.
Thinks better of it. Nice big pot for Bernard.
No. You can't see those cards.
Please. A little higher next time, right?
Richard, you'll have to watch a TV broadcast.
Hey, look over there real quick. Good bet.
The Windy City Poker Championship is taking a break. But before we do, listen in to what the pros talk about during commercials.
Just donking some chips away here. I had a pair.
Would you have like eight?
I had a pair.
You had a pair there?
Yeah.
I had 3-4.
So you had a gut shot and a pair. You can stay. I'll play you.
Good meeting you. Now Bernard's going to tell us what he had.
No.
The winning hand.
The winning hand, yeah.
Yeah, there you go.
Thanks.
Mr. Bernard had 2 pair.
It wasn't worth it. For 2,800 more, wasn't for sure. And you're behind me. You're the wild card on this end.
Yeah. No. If you call, I'll call. See one card.
Well, Dennis, what'd you have? Did he say what he had?
You didn't say what you had in that hand, right?
No. Did not. No. Yeah, I did not say.
Welcome back to Windy City Poker Championship. I'm here at the Horseshoe Casino in Hammond, Indiana for the WSOP Academy. I'm joined by professional poker player Bernard Lee. Bernard, a lot of players at home, they play in, you know, $25 buy-in tournaments. Right. And then they take that step up and they get into a $250 higher tournament. What are some of the things that they need to know when they go from that lower buy-in to the bigger events?
Well, a lot of people who are playing in tournaments that are lower buy-ins are probably taking a little bit more chances, playing cards that aren't really solid cards. So they're playing cards that what we will often refer to as danger hands. And a lot of times when you're playing in tournaments like that, you might get lucky, you know? So you're playing in an event that might have 3 hours worth of play at someone's house. You can't sustain luck for 10, 12 hours like you could in 3 hours. So to be playing those kind of cards in general, you're not going to be successful. So it's really a completely different set of tools that you're really going to need when you go to a $250 buy-in or higher.
And some of those things that players need to learn, you guys teach that at the Academy. For the average poker player, what are some of the things that they can benefit from by attending the Academy?
Well, basically everything we just talked about. So we're talking about the danger hands, talking about tells, talking about everything of how to basically get to become a good poker player.
Yeah.
Everyone believes that they're much better, and I don't need teaching. I don't need help. Everyone needs help. Coming to a WSOP Academy is as close as you're going to get, and also have it not, you don't just ask questions, we're going to teach you how to play the game to another level.
And you guys don't even coddle the players. You tell them the nitty-gritty, like, this is what you did,
no,
this is why it was wrong.
I have no remorse. And I did it today probably three times, and I literally said, I'm sorry, I'm saying this to you, and I'm not trying to belittle you amongst all of these other people, but I'm just telling you, that was flat out wrong.
Well, it's a great experience to have at the WSOP Academy. For more information, log on to WSOPacademy.com. We'll be right back after this message.
Dennis, I will say that every time I try that move on a bluff on tour, everyone calls me. So I try to do it that way when I really have it.
Yeah.
And now everyone folds.
Yeah. Said all I had was a pair. I wasn't that strong. It low surprised me when both of you called me on the there's a 2-3-6 out there. Okay, I got an overpair, no problem. I make a bet, two calls. Wasn't gonna get in the middle of it. Even if I had the best hand, I just wasn't gonna get in the middle of that. No problem.
You had an overpair to the flop, right?
Look at this table. What are the random chances?
I thought it was a good card. I didn't want to see an ace, king, or queen.
I don't deny that.
You know, I thought it was a really, really good card.
Yeah.
There still could be an overpair here. I flopped a set. I almost raised on the flop, and I probably should have. You know, a little bit, and probably at least one of you probably may call. You know?
I might have actually
right.
on that.
If I make it like 25 or whatever,
I'd
if
had
you
a hard
call,
time.
Then you might have called.
Yeah.
Maybe. Yeah. You know, I still have the little pair in the gut
right.
shot. Then
I probably
I have a hard time laying down that pair right there
right.
on the flop.
Right. Well, you don't know where I stand.
Exactly.
You know, I could have ace jack. You know.
It's time to look at the featured table chip leaderboard. In first place is Nico with 42,000. In second is Ted with 27,950. Dennis Phillips is in third with 24,775. And Chicago's own Jason Finn has 22,100. Blinds are 100 to 200, and we have some new players at the table, Chris. That's Jason Finn, also known as Chicago Jason.
Now replacing Brian Amon is Jesse Nunes.
And Paul Fisher is taken off, and in his place is Ted Leahy.
So the way we're doing it is here, you have to show us your cards when you sit down at the table the first time. And
just the first rotation?
Yeah, is that okay?
But only a gentleman in seat two.
But you can still play him.
Oh, sorry.
We're nice.
I always get the bad draw.
Yeah, you are actually allowed to play them after you show them. It's a rule that we invented.
It's a little thing we're doing here to make it more interesting.
First I show them, then I ask if you want
yes,
action,
exactly.
And then I make my wager.
Get a raise?
You do want action.
Also, we're doing shots every once in a while because we're in an Irish place. So.
Sure. Yeah, all right.
And by the way,
it's yours,
I know
sir.
This sounds amazing, but it's the guy in seat two's turn to buy.
Yeah, but also,
what are the chances? This is ridiculous. This is a statistically significant evening.
So what's the watch work? Let's just get it out there for the round.
See, we should have been saying when the Garage King was here that we make him
the Garage King, man. It's almost like Abe Froman, the Sausage King of Chicago, but he's the Garage King of Chicago. You know, so
he has his table housed.
There's a movie reference.
Do you like movies? Do you watch movies?
No, I've never seen anything. Is there anything good out right now?
Richard has not seen any good movies.
So somebody came
you
up see, to me during.
You should have said, I hate movies. I can't stand them.
Somebody came up to me during the break. They're like, what should I see? And I go, well, are you stupid or smart? Because I can make a recommendation based on that. You know?
All right, no one wants to play this pot so far.
I must have a huge hand then. Or maybe not.
Oh, am I supposed to be showing the whole camera here?
Yeah.
I think I missed it once. You got
the. You know, Jason's all new with this TV thing.
We haven't had one of these yet. Let's be friendly.
Oh, Mike checks his pocket sixes. That's interesting.
Tell him
let's
friendly would
develop.
Walk.
Yeah, I say it, but I don't know if I mean it.
Another king. Another check. Another check. I didn't like that there.
Yeah. I think he's been. Oh. See what happens?
I play the board.
Mike gets counterfeited. Both players will be playing the board.
Do you have over an eight?
Oh, wow.
Oh, wow, we chop.
That's what they call too
maybe
friendly poker.
Maybe a little
poker.
Too friendly over there, I'm just saying.
Split pot.
Listen, yeah. How do you
want a six
to do that?
Throw a six out there, man.
Wow.
Four
that's just not right. I was at a humorless table over there, too. I was like, geez, guys, you know, the first 10 minutes, headphones, sunglasses, everything. Like, really?
Line still 100, 200.
The guy to my left. There was a few really talented players, actually, guys that I've seen play or that I've played with before.
Oh, really? Yeah.
And a couple guys who just play cards.
The action's going to be on Jesse.
And the guy to my left in the first level went into this whole speech, went into the tank, I mean, before the flop, and then folded ace-king face up, and I was like, take it easy.
Like, dude, relax. I had a guy, I was at a charity tournament recently, and a guy called a clock on a woman who had obviously never played poker in her life.
Is it just a two so far?
I'm going to raise.
Clock.
And he called a clock on a woman. I'm like, I don't even think there's anybody over here.
I think you'll notice
really?
Every time Richard talks to the dealer, he has
a
big
like,
hand.
You know, we're at a muscular dystrophy, you know, benefit, and he called a clock. And he goes, I'm playing for a seat in the World Series Poker. I go, no, you're playing for a charity, idiot.
Holds around to Ted, who's going to make the call.
I was embarrassed for the guy. And again, of course, he got knocked out later. And I was like, I love it. I mean, this is like a woman who's like, hit the little plastic card where you look up the, you know, the hands. And
right,
everything,
right.
You know? I'm like, really? You know.
Did you ask him afterwards how that was working out, the quest for the seat?
That's what you say is a pretty good flop for Richard's hand. He's really playing the conversation up at that table well, Chris.
Yeah, he fills on the turn.
I check.
Still checking.
When you gotta go, you gotta go.
It's gotta bet something.
1,300.
Very confident. No way Ted could call.
I'm gonna look that one up later.
I'm missing that bet on the turn. I think you bet bigger on the river, and maybe somebody thinks you're bluffing at it.
And that's why you're in the booth.
Excuse me, gentlemen.
There goes Nico. We hear he just went to the bathroom.
Oh, I hope he can find a flush.
Did you bet on the river? Did you bet on the river? I just tossed the thing, so I wasn't paying attention.
I had queens, so I had a queen's full. Pretty good hand. I kept waiting for him to do something. I'm like, come on, dude.
Come on, bet.
I flop top set, hit the seven. I'm like, really?
You're not going to do anything.
I think he took my chatter to mean like I was, you know, overdoing it. I was just chattering anyway.
So, you know, Dennis Phillips knocked me out of a tournament earlier tonight with 7-high, I believe.
7-9.
Yeah, well, he's a donkey. I wouldn't play with that turkey.
He played it perfectly.
What were you playing, Pinnacle?
Yeah, I don't know how the 7 got in there.
I was gonna say, yeah.
No, I had a baby pair, and he had to call me, and the board paired twice.
Battle the blinds.
That's what's called crippling the deck.
I think Jesse's interested in this hand now.
Flopping a full house, hoping Dennis has anything.
Don't get frisky.
No.
See, and now Jesse, he's going to bet the turn, unlike Richard did last time.
Uh-huh.
That's why I'm usually at the table and not in the booth.
And let's see if he gets a call here. No, see, he should have waited to the river. Takes on a small pot. I'm sure he wishes he got more there. First pot for Jesse. Coming up after the break, our poker reporter Catherine Crane chats with Dennis Phillips. Stay tuned. Welcome back to Windy City Poker Championship, the only televised poker show from Chicago.
Let's take a look at the chip leaderboard for the featured table.
guys. I'm here with Dennis Phillips. Now, Dennis, you won a lot of money last year. What are you going to be doing this season?
Oh, winning more. You know, it's real simple. I figure if I win a lot of money, then, you know, that's all good. No, I'm doing a lot of things right now. I'm playing in a whole lot of different tournaments, a lot of charity ones. I'm involved in 22 different charities actively. I'll be playing a lot of the LAPTs, the NAPTs, the rest of those, traveling around the world. I put over 200,000 miles in the air this last 12 months. American Airlines loves me. So anyhow, but I'll be just more of the same.
Now, how is it different playing in a charity tournament like this?
Oh, it's a lot different. Whenever you sit down at a table, you try and make new friends, at least I do, and I have a good time. But it's not quite as serious. It is for a good benefit. No matter who wins, you got to cheer them on.
Now, how long have you been playing poker for?
I started playing poker all the way back in college, which was a long time ago. But Texas Hold'em only about the last 5 or 6 years, and I've only really been playing serious in tournaments about 3 years.
What do you like to do when you're not playing poker?
Anything I can. Let me tell you, I love work with the charities. I love sports of all kind. I've got season tickets for all the different sports in St. Louis. I travel around. I'll be going to the Super Bowl. I was at the All-Star game. I'm having fun.
Thanks so much, Dennis. Back to you guys.
Thank you, Catherine. That was a great interview with Dennis Phillips. He drove all the way up here from St. Louis, Chris.
You know, I had a chance to talk to him as well, and he told me that he preferred the drive because he had spent so much time in the air with Poker Stars.
Excuse me, sir. It's a little bit higher with the cards.
Oh, sure. I just don't want Bernard to see him.
Next time, tell him and turn them this way.
Sir, can you put one card on your head?
You know, my camera's not working, but I'll just call him out and you write him down.
Well, that's an excellent idea, Jason. Jason's always so helpful.
Yeah. And I think he's such a good player that he probably could still win a pot with everyone knowing his cards.
The mark. The
What is it, 1-2 still?
1-2.
Huh. Apparently Jason's conversation is not exciting enough for Richard. He needs to get involved in this hand.
And throw a fit or something so you get a little TV time. Just like get up and go, I can't believe these guys
play change.
Here's a real hand. Ace-queen for Mike.
Please.
No, just, I don't know if I can do. I don't know if I can do that one, dude.
You don't know if I can. Okay.
I only have fives.
Thank you. I'm gonna raise.
Re-raise.
Jesse has big slick. Maybe it's the seat, Scott.
Maybe. Maybe.
Whoever sits in that seat always gets a bigger ace than the initial raiser.
It's 800. What do you please?
A raise and a raise?
A raise and a raise.
Oh, I don't want to get in the way of that.
Call. Mike's going to make the call. We're heads up to the flop.
This is what's tricky about playing ace-queen.
Two jacks and a tray. Everyone misses. Five of diamonds on the turn. Little feeler bet from Jesse. Thinking his hand is good. In disgust. He had a nice hand going in, but never caught up.
As you always say, Chris, fit or fold.
There's Nico. I wonder if he'll give us some Axe body spray.
You know, Chris, we haven't seen much from Nico lately, but we certainly can smell him. That Axe body spray. Good.
I think he put that on when he went to the restroom. All right, back to the action. Here's Jason with sailboats, pocket fours. He's going to get involved.
Nice bet.
500.
Makes it five.
Let's put in 5,000.
You're on the big line, right? You're raising
Richard,
your hand.
Why
are you doing that?
With that little sneaky 500. Taking me along for the ride.
Folds all the way around to Richard in the big blind.
I'm just going to show you what I have.
All right. Ask me if I want action.
Is this the two of us right here? You want to look at one?
Sure.
And Jason takes his first pot, albeit a small one.
Jack 3.
You had one over to my pair, sir.
You had a pair of nines?
Maybe.
Small blind, big blind.
I'm going to remember that now. In fact, I'm going to put these green chips here. on top of this pimp hat.
You know, anything is good in moderation.
Hey, look.
You find the extremists.
There are countries you can't do that, you know?
Because they're all babies.
You wouldn't be allowed to walk outside.
Exactly.
You do that in
Mike
certain countries,
Jack 4
you're going to jail.
Lets it go. Dennis with a big hand, ace king.
500.
100. Player raises, makes it 5.
Fold.
Never one's folding to the pro.
Bully. Bully.
No, he's not a bully. He's a man with a hand.
Ooh, not bad. Shuffleboard.
Do you like that?
You spent too many times in a bar. Shuffleboard there. If you would have done something, you going for the trifecta here, guys. Three in a row.
He was going after the
I usually have a train of women holding the, you know, the cord behind me.
Our blinds are up, Chris. 100, 200 with a 25 ante.
You know, this is the portion of the tournament when players start to get aggressive. There's more money in the middle.
I got lost after you said train of women.
It's a good
behind
time
you
to start playing some hands that you might normally not play.
We all do, Dennis. That's when we get lost.
Certainly is a jovial table, Chris.
You want to raise?
Hey, it was only 13.
Mike announces raise. Pocket queens, good hand to raise with.
It's got the ladies. Oh, and Dennis has pocket tens right behind him.
Listen to me, that's a race. This isn't 2 days from now, you're going to hear something.
Going to call behind.
This could get ugly if there's a baby flop.
Three in a row.
Remember, I'm the ringer.
Okay.
And they're like, they're airing it. They're like, we have an interview for you.
Five.
Jason lets his hand go.
Over to the blinds, Bernard Lee. Six tray. Okay, we'll be four away to the flop.
Look at that. I guess this is going to be one of the John cans, Chris. Nico flops top two.
1,000.
This could be a big pot.
Player calls.
Raise.
Player calls is a raise.
At the end, it was like, you know, women you'd want to put a half of that over
here.
3,700.
All day.
Raises to 3,700. Tough spot for Mike here. Nico can make this with any jack.
Phil knows what I'm talking about. That's not good shit. That's
right. And nine, by the way, never matters. But I would.
I'm sure he wishes he raised a little more now, preflop.
I feel your pain, Mike. I've been there often.
Nice lay down.
Wow, look at that lay down.
Could I have misplayed this any worse? Yeah, he said 37 total.
Dennis trying to get some information.
And you're the one in the big blind. You could have any two cards with the pot odds you had. $27 more.
We had a bet, a call, and a raise. He probably knows he's beat. I'm sure he's wondering if Nico's on a draw.
Wow. Nico not looking weak.
Check raise to it.
I'm a gentleman, Dennis. I will show you.
No, I'm not worried about that.
Nico confident now he has the best hand.
It's got to be some stupid thing like Jack Deuce or type thing.
Dennis going through the range of hands.
All righty. Good bet.
Finally lets it go.
I think he's disgusted, but it's a good lay down.
Jack
Nico
four,
shows
like
the
said.
Two pair. I'm sure that makes Mike happy.
Yeah, I did.
Nice pot for Nico.
Thank you.
Wasn't hard to put you on the hand. I should have re-raised in pre-flop. I just, yeah, no, it's bad play on my part.
Did you throw away tens or tens?
Huh?
You threw away tens?
Yeah.
I threw away queens.
Had to.
Wow. How do you not broke?
Don't go away. After this short commercial break, one of these seven players will be eliminated from the tournament. Stay tuned. Welcome back to the Windy City Poker Championship. Let's take a look at the featured table chip leaderboard. Nico has 45,475 chips in first place. Ted, our lucky Leahy poker table maker, has 26,425 chips. He's in second. Our poker pros, Dennis Phillips and Bernard Lee, are each hovering around 20,000. And the short stack is movie critic Richard Roper with 12,750 chips.
Line still 100, 200 with a 25 ante.
I think I'm betting about 300 on my whole cam.
Haven't heard the dealer say ante up yet, Chris.
I'm very disappointed.
Did not get the memo.
Nuts. It's a proper bet there and everything. Well played.
Folds to Richard Roper. Folds is 10-4.
Jack 5 monster hand for Jason.
Raise.
He's going to raise, too.
This is what is known as playing the players and the position.
Keep it out there. Call.
That's your change.
I called.
Oh, you called?
Mike defends.
Makes the call with this 10-9.
Okay, so.
Pot's 1,300 as we go to the flop.
I did not hear the word call. I apologize.
Seven of spades, king of hearts, six of clubs.
Quick check from Mike. Wants to see what Jason's going to do now.
750.
750 is the bet.
Yeah, not much reason for Mike to stay in there.
Jason was bluffing with the best hand there.
You were loaded.
Huh?
You were powerful. You were loaded there.
Thank you. You, sir, have the power of observation.
And he hated that king.
Yeah, he did.
Shake it off. Dude, you got off. You got off easy.
No. Boom. There's the four of us.
You should have been broke on that hand. I cannot believe it.
That's right.
100,
200. Sorry,
guys. I'll get you changed in a moment. No
problem. I can do that much. Oh, thank you, sir.
That'll
be easier
for me to
board.
So much easier to
board. I must have something huge.
200?
I call.
I get the feeling Richard likes to see flops.
Race.
Player announces a raise.
650.
And look at this, Jason puts in a raise with queen eight to 650.
Nico calls.
You change in a moment.
Mike gets out of the way. It's on Dennis now. 10-7 offsuit.
That's the favorite hand of his fellow pro from PokerStars, Daniel Negreanu.
That's correct.
I call.
Makes the call. All the way back around
got
to Richard.
Down
four,
there.
450 more to me.
Are you sensing frustration with Dennis?
I do kind of sense that a little bit. So the 10-7, it's going to be interesting to see what happens on this flop.
All right, fellas, let's get this game out of the muck.
I'm calling. No one giving Jason's raise respect.
What's the chance that Nico thinks he's ahead right now with his king-queen?
Finally see a flop. Queen of diamonds, 10 of hearts, 5 of diamonds. Can see some serious fireworks here. Nico and Jason both hit top pair.
Richard is open-ended.
Nico bet 16-25. That's a nice bet into a multi-way pot. Dennis gets out of the way.
Call.
Oh.
I don't think Jason likes a lot of players in this hand with him.
I raise.
And there you go. He's going to raise. He makes it 50-50. 5,025.
5,050. I think he made that bet just so we could say 50-50.
I think he did. He knew we were in the booth today.
He's so creative.
Nico confused by the check raise. And he lets go the winner. You know, I like that fold. He thought through the hand, only had one pair.
That orange chip is powerful.
And delicious.
And nutritious.
That's right. 17-1.
What do you have? What are those two cards?
17-1.
No, I mean, what are those two cards you have?
Oh, I can't tell you.
Richard can't call here. He's not getting a good price.
Oh, I don't have one of those orange chips.
Show the set.
Another nice move from Jason. That's how he got his nickname, Chicago Jason.
Show the set. I showed mine.
That's good. It's good for the game.
I can't show you.
I won't look. Everybody else can look. And you
I can't do it. Can't show you my cards.
Yeah, you can.
You know how I play.
Yeah, you can.
Mine has a couple of jackets that he bought and put in the closet, so when people came in without them. And the first guy who came in ended up with this coat that was like five sizes too big. The next guy came in was a big dude.
Oh, that's great.
And he was like trying to get the coat on. I was like, oh, this is... Like,
wow, action okay, starts with Ted. Card.
Yeah, exactly. I think David's.
And what great cards to start the action with. Two black kings. Raises to 750.
Get out of the way of King Kong.
What's up, gentlemen?
How are you?
Hello,
you
sir. Doing? Dave, nice to see you.
Oh, no.
Raise is 750 all day.
Now we got a new player joining us. Replacing Nico is Dave Backstrom. Sits down with 31,800 chips.
Okay, if you insist.
Down to Dennis with ace seven suited.
Wow.
650.
The dealer must have sensed this would be the last hand of the show. Wanted to make it exciting.
I'm really glad you guys came. This is a lot of fun.
Yeah. We'll go to the flop four way.
It's fun, though, isn't it? I mean, it's like, I mean, are you kidding me? Whether I play tomorrow or get knocked out tonight? I mean, are you kidding me? How much fun is this?
Right, yeah, absolutely.
Nine of diamonds, three of spades, five of clubs. This could get ugly.
2,000.
Ted's gonna raise here.
Raise.
Good call, Chris.
Thank you.
Makes it 5,000 to go.
Folds around the Jesse. Just makes the call.
He's got some fireworks at this table, huh?
Oh, we're doing karaoke. We got all kinds of stuff going on.
I like it.
On to the turn. Three of hearts. Both players have two pair.
Jesse sizing up Ted's stack.
He can't get away from this.
Five.
The bet is five.
It's tough here for Ted because Jesse just called his raise on the flop, but now is betting out again on the turn.
Just a call.
Wow.
Onto the river. Ten of spades, all undercards to their pairs.
The rest of it.
Jesse's going to go all in. It's really his only play.
9-3. That is correct. 9,300 is the bet.
It's a big pot, 32,000.
Be a pretty good hand, too.
Ted's going to have to think long hard about this.
He could be thinking that Jesse has a set. Could have had a suited ace tray, maybe turn three of a kind. It's a long drive from Georgia, and it's a long drive back.
I'm set of nines, huh?
It still is just a pair of kings.
Even the dealer's nervous. He's taking a swig of his water. It's a big hand.
Yeah, the rest of the night would be a lot easier if I missed this one.
The way Jesse's played this hand, it's tough to put him on a hand. Not giving any information to Ted.
He makes a call. He makes a call. We're going to have our first casualty.
Oh, wow.
Jesse shows his queens. Ted shows his winner. That's it for Jesse. He's out of the Windy City Poker Championship season finale.
Nice game, man.
Yeah, man.
Pair over pair.
Nice playing with you.
Oh, Ted breathes a sigh of relief.
Hey, what are you going to do?
I'm sitting here thinking, man, I can fold kings. I can fold kings. Not with that board. Not with that board.
That's all the action we have tonight.
Be sure to tune in next time to see some more featured play of some of Chicago's finest rounders.
Right here on the Windy City Poker Championship.
Be sure to take advantage of affordable primetime sponsorship on Windy City Poker Championship. For more information on advertising or sponsoring a program, send us an email or call 708-935-2861.
I think I was behind him by one.
Jack, back, queens.
Yeah.
No, we know he had deuces.
He had deuces.